B.Y.O.B. Bring your own board. Where board riders of the wind, ocean, and land connect to see their dreams come true. Every week, viewers will tune into the lives of those who make a living by the ocean in the most unreal way. Who would ever think riding a board, a surreal dream, could come true if you go professional and end up earning millions a year? And if you don't make it there, you might be lucky enough to launch a multi-million dollar board company.
My phone's been going off the hook, like all day.
But to get to the top, these dreamers will have to go the distance and risk it all. And if they land the right way, the dream of owning a swimsuit collection sold around the world, or becoming a board maker for the tens of millions of board riders, can lead to a life beyond your wildest dreams. They're not just making a company or a brand or hunting for one to sponsor them. They're building a way of life.
Open my eyes to an early sunrise. Clear blue skies, so it's time to check the tide. Grab my
From faraway locations like Hawaii, Costa Rica, Puerto Rico, Mexico, and right in California, the dream makers are out to live the ultimate fantasy.
I got a melody keeping my soul.
Coming up later, connect with one of our featured music artists in the Music Zone.
I can't let go.
Career that takes you traveling around the world? As long as you can get there by plane, boat, or your board, at all costs is the prized jewel, the way of life. So let's go meet some of the board riders and dreams on this episode of BYOB, Bring Your Own Board.
In a land full of jungle terrain, larger than life iguanas, and some of the best hidden surf in South America, we head to the Costa Rican rainforest to experience Pura Vida at the biggest eco-musical festival in the world, Envision Fest.
Muita
Meet Dan Bailey.
Okay, we play at 6 at the Village
yeah,
Stage.
I'm gonna be there.
Awesome. Toilet, man. Beautiful. And I'll come for you at 9. Definitely.
A nomadic rock musician and board rider who lives the ultimate fantasy that many could only dream of.
Ah, ja, ja.
He hails from Long Island and travels the world nearly full-time with his girlfriend Lauren, who also is a surfer, artist, and who helps him produce his music videos.
We came straight from Hawaii. We had a brief, you know, one day in LA and flew straight over here and went straight from the airport to rehearsal. So it was pretty wild, but it worked out really well because, you know, the guys were really prepared. We came to this awesome little spot called Vintage Studio in San Jose, and they had everything ready for us, drum set, mics, amps, everything we needed was there. And, you know, the guys speak a bit of English, but I was trying to also communicate in Spanish, and, you know, it ends up being mostly just kind of sign language and beatboxing to, you know, explain the music and how I wanted it to go. But yeah, they did a really great job and we had a lot of fun.
Navigating through the rainforest by car is difficult, and having no streets or address makes ordinary trees and rocks critical landmarks when trying to find our next stop, the Mango Tree Villa and Spa, for a night's rest before the big festival begins. As we unpacked, we saw the remarkable views that overlook the villa above the national rainforests of Uvita. With the coast in sight beyond the tree line, the surfboards are kept handy for an early sunrise surf sesh. At the peak of dawn, we head out to Playa Dominical to explore the waters and hidden surf breaks. Upon arrival, the magical surf bus is discovered.
The SoFi Project is an artistically sustainable mobile community. We left Oregon, the States, 5.5 years ago on this bus. It's our home and studio. We converted the bus to run on used vegetable oil and solar power.
It's a cyclical filtration process, so it goes in a cycle. Once it's done filtering, you pump it all to the final tank under the bus.
Over the last 5.5 years, we've developed a repertoire of music and been playing as a band all through Central America. Been able to support the project entirely off of our music. And at the same time working in sustainability projects around Central America, doing workshops on sustainability like recycling techniques, composting techniques, bicycle machines, solar ovens, rocket stoves, vegetable oils, and alternative fuel. Solar power, all sorts of stuff like that. With schools, indigenous communities, organizations that we met along the way. Worked a bit in film, doing short films, promotional videos for organizations that are working with the same sort of focus and need help sort of getting promotion and getting their voice out there. So yeah, it's a multifaceted project that has been successfully making its way south for the last 5 years. A lot slower than we had ever thought it would be, but we've been soaking up a lot more than we ever thought we would as well.
We are taken into the surf bus and given a tour of the remodeled interior.
So we bought it as a school bus, and it had like 30 seats on both sides. We took them all out and started to build from the back. Back here we built 8 bunk beds. There's 8 beds back here. This is the dormitory area. For the first few years of the project, it was just this mass flow, influx, and, you know, ebb and flow of people. And yeah, it was in the first years kind of just gaining its sort of like focus, you know, and sort of getting like its feet planted in like what are the sort of mission and vision of the project. And so, yeah, but in the last 2 years, that's become a lot more solidified and we've developed a lot more sort of solid focus.
Outside of the surf bust, a spontaneous drum circle is created by the beach. Our cast joins in the circle and jams with the locals. However, Envision Fest is about to begin, so we pack up the surfboard and head into the Uvina Rainforest to check in. Upon arrival, we run into old faces from past festivals.
Bernie Man.
How you doing?
Yeah.
Hugging and embracing our friends. The surrounding scenery is full of vibrant festival goers and colorful treetops.
Burst into flame.
For lovers of boards in the ocean, plug into the Surf Zone.
Won this contest 2 years in a row. Their style last year was they're playing dirty. They got a good chance of winning over there because it's smaller waves and they're used to surfing smaller waves. They got some good waves, but the problem is there's so much traffic and tourists and like no parking. It's just like freaks me out. I just want to go home in the North Shore where it's just like peaceful, peace, quiet. Kind of surfing you see on the North Shore is radical. Whether it's doing big crazy airs, big crazy turns, or getting big crazy barrels, or getting huge waves at Waimea, it's a radical place, and you gotta be a radical person to do all those things out here. I don't know who's gonna be on the South Shore team. I'm sure they're gonna have some rippers, and we're gonna have some shredders, and we're gonna go battle.
We're here at the Honolulu International Airport on the south side of Hawaii. Southside has more refined reefs, channels that create these perfectly refined little waves. Red Bull Rivals is an event where it's a rivalry, you know, South Shore versus North Shore. I mean, it's a long-standing rivalry that's been going on from the beginning of competitive surfing. Having this event kind of distinguishes like who has the bragging rights for the year. The waves look like they're better on the left, so we're gonna send out all our goofy foots.
Title in a row. Give your board to the south side.
We're pretty excited. I mean, 2013, you know, on the North Shore. Hopefully we can beat them in their own territory, and then it'll be, you know, it'll be 4 years in a row.
Sure, and burning it so you